you had to have a sense of humor. Now, I didn't laugh for 3 months. That's how serious it was. 3 months without laughing, and I had these three other cellmates. And so I remember one day we got called out for an interrogation, but it was a holiday. It was really not an interrogation. It was kind of a indoctrination, little speech by the camp officer in the camp, and he had his two turnkeys that opened the door and let us in and out, and they spoke a little English, and they were sitting on either side of him, and he's behind the desk with his arms crossed like this and very pompously bragging about the Communist Party and all the good things they were doing and how bad the U.S. was and all, and we're sitting on these little milking stools, so our heads are about that much lower than his. And so they had a thermos, old-time thermos there, and it had a cork top in it, and he pulled it out, and they poured us a little bit of, tiny little bit of coffee in a little Demitasse cup to show how wonderful they were being to us and treating us special on this holiday. And so we drank it, and they said, well, you can have some more. So I reached over and grabbed the thermos and poured a little bit into everybody's cup, and I went to put the stopper back in the top, and I pushed it too hard, and it just went straight down inside the thermos. And when I did, the turnkey, he was my turnkey there, his eyes got so big, like he was terrified. He didn't know what was going to happen. He didn't know what to do. You know, it's like, oh, one of my guys has made a big mistake here. And the expression on his face was priceless. And we got back, we didn't laugh then, but when we got back to our cell, we were just rolling in the floor laughing about Mark's, we call him Mark, Mark's expression on his face and of just stark terror. So it was, that was a lot of fun. And whenever we could pull a little stunt on them and get away with it, that was always good. You know, it kind of raised our morale. They were always trying to deny our self-esteem, our self-worth, because if they could get us in that role, then we're much more vulnerable to be exploited. And we were always fighting to maintain our self-worth and dignity. Louis Zamperini talks about this in his book Unbroken, how the Japanese POW camp commanders tried to destroy their self-worth and how they fought back to maintain their self-worth. And I think anytime you're in that kind of situation, it's very important to you. You got to have that feeling of, you know, I'm okay and I'm still in the fight here. I haven't lost all my power.